Hello students, Hemant sir is here. So today we are going to continue with the next part of our chapter. The name of chapter is the chemicals and chemical equation. Okay, so in previous part we have already covered about the introduction part. What are elements? What are atoms? How many atoms do we have in our modern periodic table? Then we have already understood about their chemical symbols and few chemical compounds. Okay, so today we are going to understand about the atomicity. Okay, so let's start. What is atomicity? Okay, so today we will continue with the part called atomicity. Okay, so what is atomicity? Atomicity is defined as the total number of atoms present in a molecule or any compound is called as atomicity. Okay, what is atomicity? The total number of atoms present in a molecule is called as its atomicity. Okay, each molecule of oxygen, for example, we are just considering, for example, oxygen is composed of two oxygen atoms. Okay, that means it present in our nature in the form of O2. That means oxygen in its molecule contain two oxygen atoms. Therefore, its atomicity is 2. Okay, so the atomicity of oxygen is beta, it is 2. Okay, it is very, very important. Okay, now we will discuss about types of atomicity. Okay, so molecules of an element, they are divided into 4 categories. Number 1, we have monoatomic. Monoatomic means those molecules, they are having only single atom. Okay, in their molecular form are called as monoatomic molecules. Like example, we have helium, neon, krypton, okay, argon, okay, argon and krypton, they are the example of monoatomic molecules. Okay, only one atom or element is present. Now we have second type, it is the diatomic molecules. So what are diatomic molecules? Those molecules, they contain 2 atoms in their molecular form are called as beta diatomic. Like we have O2, we have 2 oxygen atoms in one molecule. Okay, we have N2, again in nitrogen, we have 2 nitrogen. Okay, in nitrogen molecule, we have 2 nitrogen atoms. Chlorine gas, which is present in Cl2 form. So here again we had 2 chlorine atom, okay, Cl and Cl. Then we have hydrogen, okay, again hydrogen is present in H2 form. So it is H2 form contain 2 atom of hydrogen, that's why it is diatomic molecule. Okay, now we have triatomic molecule. Okay, we have triatomic molecule. So what are triatomic molecule? Those molecules which have 3 atoms in their molecules are called as beta triatomic molecules. Example, we have ozone. Okay, ozone is the best example for triatomic molecule. Then we have polyatomic molecule. Polyatomic molecules means those molecules having 3 or more than 3 atoms in their molecule are called as beta polyatomic molecule. Example, we have phosphorus, okay, which is present in P4 form. P4 form. Then we have sulfur, okay. Then we have again like many compounds and elements or like molecules we have, they present in more than 3 atoms in their structure. Okay, like we have S6, it is sulfur. Okay, sulfur is present in S6, means 6 atoms are present here in sulfur molecule. So they are nothing but their atomicity. Okay, so what is atomicity now? The total number of atoms present in a particular molecule is called as beta its atomicity. Okay, I hope you have understood this concept very well. Okay, so take a screenshot for that. Okay, so now we will understand the next concept. Okay, so let's discuss here one more time, like different types of atomicity. So we already discussed that first one is monoatomic, consists of only one atom, like we have chlorine. Okay, wait a second. We have sodium. Okay, we have magnesium. Okay, etc. Then we have helium also. We have neon, okay, we have argon, we have krypton, we have xenon. Okay, these are the example of monoatomic molecule. Then we have diatomic. So what are diatomic? Diatomic are the molecule having two atoms, like we have oxygen, okay, we have nitrogen, etc. We have hydrogen also. Then we have triatomic molecule, like we have ozone, okay, they contain three atoms. And polyatomic means what? Consist of more than three atoms in their molecule are called as polyatomic molecules. And generally metals are like monoatomic molecules. Most of the metals they present in their individual state. Okay, that's why they are generally monoatomic molecule. Okay. Now we will understand the chemical symbols. Okay, so what are chemical symbols basically? So chemical symbols are nothing but the representation of the molecule. Okay, the representation of molecule of a compound by using chemical symbols. Okay, of its constituent element is called as beta chemical symbol. Okay, suppose if you want to represent the water in the form of chemical symbol, so you will use it is H2O. It is H2O is nothing but the water molecule's chemical symbol. Okay, then we have the salt that we use every day in our daily diet. Okay, the salt we use to add in vegetables. Okay, and we used to eat it is nothing but the salt. And its representation is NaCl. What is Na? It is sodium and chlorine. Okay, Cl is what? Chlorine. So this again, one more example for the chemical symbol. And these all are the example of like compound we are using in our daily lives. Okay, or day-to-day life. So salt is NaCl. It is called beta sodium chloride. It is called as sodium chloride. Then we have sucrose. Sucrose means the sugar that you are having at your home. Okay. That sucrose is nothing but the sugar. Okay. And its molecular formula is C12H22O11. Then we have vinegar. It is also called as beta acetic acid. It is also called as acetic acid. And its formula is C2H3O2. Okay, and last but not the least, we have baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. Okay, it is like very useful for baking bread, toast, okay, crispy vegetables, dhoklas, idlis, and like we are using that sodium bicarbonate. It is also called as baking soda. Yeah, here it is given, it is the baking soda. Okay. So again, take a screenshot for chemical symbols. Now we will discuss about the valency. So what is valency? So valency is nothing but the combining capacity of an element. It is the combining capacity of an element is called as beta valency. That means a particular atom going to form how many bond it called as its valency. And valency is determined by number of electron present in their outermost shell. Okay. So how valency has been determined? Number of electron present in their outermost shell. Okay. So for a non-metal, you can calculate valency of the non-metal by subtracting the their number of electron from their outermost shell from the 8. Okay, like suppose we have chlorine. Chlorine has atomic number beta 17. Its electronic configuration is 2, 8, and 7. That means in outermost shell, chlorine contain 7 electron. So we had to just subtract that 7 from the 8. So 8 minus 7 equals to what? It is the 1. That means chlorine have valency 1. Okay, like this. The valence electron are the number of electron present in outermost shell of an atom. Okay, so in outermost shell, how many electrons atoms have? On that basis, we can decide their valency. Okay, for example, we have for carbon. So carbon have atomic number 6. So 2 electron will come in first shell, and these 4 electron will occupy the space in second orbit. Okay, now in case of carbon, we have total 4 electron. So we have to subtract that 4 from the 8. Okay, therefore 8 minus 4. 8 minus 4 equals to again the 4. Same. Okay, so as you can see here, the valency of carbon we have derived from the outermost shell's electron. Okay, so its valency will be beta 4. Now in case of we have neon. So neon having 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay. So any element having 8 electron in their outermost shell, they show more stability. So, but neon is having 8 electron in its outermost shell. So its electronic configuration will be beta 8 and 2. Okay. So how we have decided the valency of neon is 0? Because 8 minus 8 will be 0. Okay. Next, for the chlorine. So we already gone through that. Chlorine having 7 electron in its outermost shell. So if we will subtract 7 from 8, we will get only 1. Okay. Yes. Okay. Now we will understand about like symbol then of the element and their valency. So we have magnesium ion have valency 2. Then we have ammonia, it's ammonium, like it is NH4. Okay, so this is beta ammonium, it is positive. Okay, so its valency is 1. Then we have carbonate. Okay, carbonate's valency is again 2. Nitrate, then we have oxide, bisulfate, and ammonium, aluminium iron. So all these ion, so all these are nothing but the symbols and their valencies. Okay, so again, I want you to take a screenshot for that. So here we are going to complete our today's session. Okay, everyone. So I want you to repeat whatever the chapter part we have covered till today. Okay. So bye-bye for now.